Okay, this is a LTE end-to-end architecture, network architecture. You can see here UV is there, EUTRON is there, EPC is there. UV, EUTRON and EPC. LTE architecture mainly consists of these three components, that is UV, EUTRON and EPC. UV is what? User equipment. EUTRON is what? EUTRON is enhanced EUTRON. U is UMTS, terrestrial radio access network, or evolved EUTRON. EPC is evolved packet core. So it mainly consists of these three elements. Come to UV. UV is user equipment. So this UV makes air interface with the E node B. It makes the UV's first connection is with the E node B. You can see here LTU UV interface between UV and E node B. You can see EUTRON consists of E node B's. There are many E node B's. X2 is the interface between two E node B. So what is this E node B? E node B makes a first air interface with the UV. Its functions are radio bearer management, uplink and downlink, radio resource management, data packet scheduling and mobility management. So there is an X2 interface. What is this X2 interface? It is an interface between two E node B's. It consists of X2C and X2U. X2C is C, X2C. X2C. X2C is control plane interface. X2U is user plane interface. Next, there is a F1 interface between EPC and EUTRON. Between EPC and EUTRON, there is a S1 interface. This S1 interface separates EUTRON and EPC. Again, this S1 interface consists of S1U and S1MME. S1U is user plane interface. S1MME is control plane interface. So, S1MME, that is signaling interface between E node B and MME. Between E node B and MME, there will be S1 MME, that is control plane interface. S1 UV is U for user plane, that carries a user traffic between serving gateway and the E node B. Next, this MME. MME is a mobility management entity. Okay. MME is a mobility management entity. It manages mobility aspects in 3GPP access. Next is serving gateway. Serving gateway routes data packets from EUTRON to the EPC. Right? Along with this, it acts as an anchor for local mobility, that is inter E node B handovers. Other responsibilities like lawful intercept, charging and some policy enforcement. Next is what? PDN gateway. PDN gateway, that is packet data network gateway. It acts as a router. It routes the data packets between EPC and the external data network. Between EPC and the external data network. It is the key node for policy enforcement and charging data collection. Okay. So, other than this, there is a HSS. HSS is Home Subscriber Service. Home Subscriber Service. There, about the user information will be stored. It acts like a database. About the user information is stored in the HSS. Next, SGSN. SGSN is serving GPRS support node. This serving GPRS support node, its functions, are like compressing of the data, authentication, registration in the network. That are the functions of SGSN. PCRF, policy charging rules function. Policy and charging rules function. This entity will keep monitoring of the charging of your mobile. Like charging means which of the data package you have, what is the charge amount balance left in your mobile. Such type of things will be taken care by this PCRF. Okay, this is all about your LTE end-to-end network architecture. See here, mainly it consists of EPC, EUTRON and UV. EPC consists of PDN, serving gateway, MME, and it makes an interface with the HSS, SGSN, PCRF, packet data network, UTRON, GERN. What is this UTRON? UTRON is a 3G network. It is a 3G network and this is a 2G network. This 4G, this LTE makes a it interacts with the 3G and also 2G networks.